and welcome back to Sam's Disney Diary. It's the 2024 Epcot International Food and Wine Festival. So much to try. I'm back for part two, this time with John from Intercon. Always a great day when I can participate in the famous John Tries. Let's see if we can get all the way around World Showcase. Thanks for watching. Hit that subscribe button. Congaloosh.
Hey, friends. John from Intercot.com and
Sam from Sam's Disney Diary, and we are at the 2024 Epcot International Food and Wine Festival, day number one.
One, uno.
Day one, and we're just starting around, and we got everything, so much here, John. What are we
gonna
try?
We do. Well, we decided, since last year we kind of fizzled out once we got to the UK.
It was a fizzled out, or it was hot, or we got cool, I don't remember.
It was warm, and we were full, and it just kind of got to that point. So we decided to start where we left off last year and work our way towards Mexico and then around to the United States, France. And,
so almost like we came in the international gateway, John.
Correct.
Sort of, maybe some of us didn't. But anyway.
Like, because there really wasn't much between here and Canada.
And Canada. Yeah,
so, all right. True. Speaking of Canada,
what do you got?
All right.
The tried and true.
We have got, the tried and true filet mignon. By the way, I did pre-cut this so that we didn't have to do it.
Okay.
So
it was a fight over.
No, it was a slab, as in a traditional filet. I looked at it already. It looks delicious.
That is the filet mignon with mushrooms, garlic, and fine herb to mashed potatoes.
Yeah.
And garlic and fine herb butter.
And they got the boursin.
The boursin.
Yeah. That's like the cheese stuff, right? It's kind of like it's like a sort of a dipped cracker thing. Anyway.
Here's what I know. I have a
plug. Here's what I... Okay.
All right.
Go ahead.
Am I?
Yeah, you can.
Mushroom and meat at the same time?
I'm not a mushroom guy, so...
All right, so I'm going to take mushroom and one piece of this.
Yikes.
Thank you for pre-cutting that.
Okay, yeah, no problem. By the way, like I said, it's pink in the middle. Perfect. Yeah. I mean... It's going to be hard to beat that today.
That's great. I'm we have some ducks that are interested, by the way.
Yeah, they, Donald and Daisy, are right down here.
They are. They are.
I want to say
we'll,
hello.
We'll put this on the side, and you can feed the ducks.
Yeah, it looks good. Great. Yeah. All right, so the other thing that we have, and this one I'm just going to try, because it'd be weird otherwise, would be
the soup and the pretzel. Now, this is soup. Cheddar cheese and bacon soup with a pretzel roll.
Right, and it's been here a little bit, so we've got a little bit of film on the top, but that'll keep the warmth in. And it's about 100 degrees here, I swear, today. So I don't know if this is...
So that's always been one of the...
Right.
So we should talk about this a second, because it's Labor Day weekend.
Mm-hmm.
This is when the festival's open. We know that in the last few years, we've had that taste of the festival, which started in July.
Right.
Even hotter.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes the soup doesn't really hit the spot in August as it would in October.
I know, but I'm going to tell you.
Or November, because this goes all the way to the holidays, right?
This is really good.
I know that it's. I know that
it's a little bit salty, very cheesy, great taste. Got some bacon in there, right? Yes.
Yes, bacon.
Bacon. Oh, I mean, you just can't go wrong.
So are we
going to... And it's not super hot, by the way.
It's not. So we have things from three different booths here.
Okay.
That was Canada. We also have simmering sips. We're going to save that because that's just a dessert.
Oh,
and we also headed over to Hawaii.
I did, by the way. I picked up
Canada.
Yeah, in Canada. It was a Collective Arts Brewing audio-visual lager.
Audio-visual? That's you. That's you,
AV,
man.
AV guy.
It's the AV guy here.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lager?
Very good lager. Yeah,
it
it's got a little bit of a hoppiness to it, but yeah, go ahead. It's okay. There's alcohol in it. It kills all the germs. So,
it's not bad. It's very light. I mean, look at the color of that. It
almost
very
looks
light, like a champagne color.
But refreshing, and I think it plays very well with the steak. So, all right, moving on.
All right, moving on to Hawaii.
Hawaii.
This is the slow roasted pork slider.
Look at that.
With sweet and sour Dole pineapple chutney and spicy mayonnaise.
Oh.
So this one we might need to cut. I'm not
sure.
I was not as prepared as you were. So you go ahead and work on that one.
I'm working on it. Do you want it open face or closed face?
I don't know.
All right.
I haven't decided. It looks great.
It does.
Which, by the way, Hawaii is as soon as you walk in on the right hand side.
Okay.
We skipped some of that.
We did a little bit.
So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take almost a half that high.
That's good.
That's what I'm going to go with.
I think that's good. Okay.
I'm going to pick up this part of that one.
All right.
All right, so this is sweet and sour Dole pineapple chutney and a spicy mayo.
Okay. Oh!
The pineapple pops. You would expect that.
It's got a little bit of spice in it, doesn't it?
A little bit. Reminds me of the same spice that's on the hot dog. If you remember the spicy hot dog that they had for a while.
Oh, yeah.
Do we call that?
That's
same
good.
Type of spice.
Well, we should actually rate these as we go along.
That's right. What was the first?
Well, steak.
The filet gets a 9.
9. Easy. Cheese soup, give it an 8. Was a little bit salty, but pretty on point.
I am going to give the slider.
I'm interested.
It's good. Yeah. It's not the best. I'm going to give a 7.
I'm going to go with what you say.
All right.
Well, we're agreeing so far, pretty much.
I'm hoping that there's things better than that. I'm sure that there will be.
Yeah, you got to save your high marks, usually. But, I mean, filet.
I'll let you hold this up.
Okay, here we go.
This is the Hawaiian rice bowl. This is Spam, eggs, eel sauce, spicy mayonnaise, the same, I'm sure. And, what is that?
Furikake.
So the most interesting to me is it's Spam.
I don't know. Yeah.
Spam, eggs, eel sauce, spicy mayonnaise.
I mean, you can see the Spam right there. So, okay. Oh, look at that. There's
bubbles.
Balloons.
Bubbles. There's bubbles.
Bubbles. All right, here we go.
We're going to go with Spam and...
he's very ginger on this. Wait, hold on. Hold on.
That's good. Jessica has like a
full
house.
Oh, wow.
That's really good.
That is surprisingly good. I'm looking at my wife. My wife's like, really, Spam?
Good.
No, this is really good.
That's getting an 8. The slider got a 7. I like that better than the slider.
I'm going exactly where you're going, my friend.
I like that better than the slider.
Yeah, that was good.
Circle that one. I would eat that again. That's a Hawaiian rice bowl.
Very good. Try
also
that.
From Hawaii.
Okay.
A passion fruit cheesecake.
Yes!
With toasted macadamia nuts. Passion fruit cheesecake, toasted macadamia nuts.
Oh, oh, oh.
Nice.
There, you want me to? Well, it was either that or I was going to go in. But, all right. Cheesecake?
Passion fruit cheesecake.
Passion
I got
fruit
some of the cheesecake. Macadamia nuts on it, too. Cheesecake.
Yeah. I mean, it's hard to go wrong with cheesecake, but honestly, there's nothing special about that.
Which has me at... I'm going to give it a 6.
Yeah.
It's a good dessert. I know there are better desserts around World Showcase.
5.5.
Oh. All right, so with that...
I think he was generous with his sips.
We're going to simmering sips.
Okay.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait. Right.
What?
This is the Mowing Brewing Company Orange Mako Guava Hazy IPA.
Oh, yes. Okay, Maui Brewing Company?
I might have tried it already.
Did you?
Yeah, the Maui Brewing Company. Orange Mango Guava Hazy IPA.
Oh, that's good.
It's good.
I'm not a huge IPA guy, but...
It's a lighter IPA.
7.
I'm giving that an 8. I like that.
Okay.
I like that.
All right, probably like hoppy stuff. So, all right, hold on.
Lastly, we're going to Simmering Sips, which, by the way, is known for the drinks that they have, but we've got the guava cake with whipped cream and coconut.
It looks good.
It looks really good. I'm interested in what's down inside there, and I don't know if I got any spoons.
In the past, we found usually the desserts are the stuff that gets the highest marks.
Yeah, it's because us.
It really does, because us. Exactly.
Well, and this is what you're after. What are you going to dig into? You get the cake with the whipped cream on top.
Right.
Toasted coconut.
Hard to beat. All right, let me get some of that coconut. It looks pretty moist. I could be wrong.
Oh, it is. There's definitely guava in there. The guava fruit chunks are in there. I don't know that I expected that. It's like grapefruit chunks almost, not quite.
Interesting. Not bad.
This is a good start, John.
Yeah,
for a first stop, this is good. We just knocked out. We got everything in Hawaii, everything in Canada, and all of the food at Simmering Sips.
Yes. All right, what'd you give that?
6.
Yeah.
Not the best. It's good. Chunks of guava kind of threw me off.
Yeah, I'm going to do 5.5 on that. It not bad, but again, we know that there are better desserts.
Which there absolutely are. By the way, Simmering Sips is also where you get all the mimosas and the little mimosa container.
Very nice.
The tropical mimosa, the berry, the blood orange, fruited sour beer and sparkling wine cocktail.
That could be good, although we had a sour earlier today that Stacy gave a zero.
Yeah, some of those are
not
tough,
good.
Man.
Not good.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
And the corks are cool, of course.
So, we
more
have
stuff
a lot to
explore. Yes, indeed. So, thanks for tuning in. This is Cheers.
It's Food Wine Festival.
It's stop number two, but...
Four stops in one. And they're all right next to each other.
This literally may be the longest John Tries segment ever because of that.
We're going to the Brewing Lab, we're doing the Noodle Station, we're doing Australia, and we are doing Mexico. All where are we starting?
Indeed. So where do we want to start? Let's start with the Noodle Exchange.
The Noodle Exchange.
So okay. We've got ramen with shaved beef, shiitake mushrooms, pickled carrots, radish, shaved spicy pepper, soy egg.
It
does smoke. In a citrus sesame broth.
I don't know if you can see the egg, but it definitely
it,
looks
it
like
is there. It's does, there. It looks yes. like a real egg.
I would almost spilt this all over our lighting ring.
Oh, that's don't do that. Okay,
that would be bad. All so, right, you're gonna go with that.
I'm gonna try that one real quick. Just try some of the stuff on top. Ready, going in.
Don't get in on the Mexican. I'm just going up with some safety. There's a jalapeno right on top.
That's good. There is that pickled taste that's in there. Ooh, there's something that's hot in there too.
Yeah, the jalapeno, dude.
Oh. It's good.
This is the shiitake.
The shiitake mushroom?
Yeah.
Very good. I'm confused by the soy egg, but
we didn't try that. It's a hard-boiled egg sitting in soy.
Six. That's a six in my book.
Six and a half.
Okay.
By the way, that is one of three different bowls you can get. That's the ramen with shaved beef. They also have the Thai shrimp and rice noodles. That's interesting.
Yep.
And tofu dish, which would be your vegan option.
Exactly.
All right.
Which I am not, but...
Australia next.
There you go.
Since I did that.
Australia? Okay.
Australia. Let's go to Australia. And what are we getting in Australia?
Crikeys.
We are going for the shrimp on the Barbie. It's the grilled Bushberry spiced shrimp skewer with shrimp with sweet and sour vegetables and coconut chili sauce.
Easy
for
you to say.
This is absolutely shrimp on the Barbie.
Oh, wow.
On the skewer.
That looks really good.
It does. So we're going to use a fork and just slide them off.
Okay.
At least I hope they slide right off.
All
right. Tail still on.
A little bit of fingers.
That's all right.
Ooh.
That looks really good.
What is in that? First of all, it's spicy.
That sweet and sour vegetable and coconut chili sauce.
Oh yeah. That's chili.
There's a little zip there. I like it.
Yeah, there's a little zip. Got an interesting taste to it.
I'm gonna give that one a 7. I like it.
I'm going 6.
I like it.
On that one. Not
definitely
bad.
Some spiciness to that.
But yeah.
It is good. Now to counteract that spiciness,
okay.
Also in Australia, let's go with the
what do we have here?
What is this? This is the Lamington. Yellow cake with
It's been kind of fally.
With raspberry filled. Well, this has to go with carrying it through the heat into whoa.
Almost went right into the camera.
He saved it.
Okay.
He saved it.
Go ahead.
Yellow cake, raspberry filling, chocolate and coconut outside.
Okay. Desserts again.
Desserts for lunch.
Oh, that's good.
That's a good yellow cake. It makes me want the figment cake that's here for Festival of Arts.
But I like the, what is it?
Some sort of,
raspberry jelly in the middle. I'm a sucker for raspberry. 7.5 for me. Like that.
7.
Okay.
Right. Good.
Moving on. Mexico.
Do we have funnel cake to try later?
I hope so.
If we make it around to America.
Mexico.
Without falling
what do we have here?
First.
These are yours. I'll hold them up. You talk to them.
Okay. Mexico.
Which one are we starting with? That's why I said you could do it.
This is the Tostada. I'm just going to say that because there's only one Tostada. It's tempura batter shrimp atop fried corn tortilla. What? Guacamole, cabbage, chipotle aioli, diced mango. Man, it's tough getting all this out.
There's
a
lot of
chili, lime powder.
Now, if I remember like last time, this is a hard shell, so this was hard to cut.
Right, and I'm just going to do this while we have this. This is the Flauta de Barbacoa. Fried tortillas filled with barbacoa beef and topped with salsa verde, crema mexicana, and queso.
All right, we're going with the first one.
Okay.
Because I was able to break up this soft.
All right.
Because you do have to break that.
Oh, I do? Okay.
Yeah, it's not soft. It's going to break.
Okay. A little messy, folks, but nothing wrong with that.
We'll prepare.
Not bad. Kind of standard Mexican fare, though.
Yeah.
For all the stuff that's in it, I expected it to be a little more elevated.
I would agree.
Yeah.
I'm going 5 for John.
5 for me.
I was going to say 6. Call it 5.5.
Okay.
All right. Now this next one, I think we can cut if we have a knife.
Do we have a knife?
I don't think we do.
That's not a knife.
Yeah. That's not a knife.
Okay. This will work. Here we go. I'm just going to take a bite.
Yeah, go for it. What is this?
Ready? This would be the barbacoa.
Okay.
So here we go. Not bad.
It's not bad.
Again. Yeah, take a drink.
I'm jumping ahead here.
You could jump ahead. Again, kind of standard Mexican fare.
Yeah, I'm not.
It just.
Not the best for me. Let's
skip that. Another 5.
4.
4. Okay, the barbacoa, that's a 5. Okay, moving on. Oh, we do want to try this.
You have a drink?
Yeah, so I have got the Mango Sunrise Margarita.
Mango Sunrise. You had this last year.
Did I?
You did, and you liked it.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure that you did. I'm going on the other side.
Hold on. It's been sitting a while, folks. All right, now try it.
Thank you.
All right, I'm going to try again because I got a lot of ice cube.
Is that water. Habanero?
Oh, that is tasty.
All right.
It's smoky.
It's got a 6.
It's got a chili lime salt. Ring.
Maybe it's a salt that I'm...
7.5.
I said 6. I got it. I get another drink.
I do like it. But it did need to be mixed up. So.
All right, last stop is right here where we are.
All right,
this
we're
is
in the
Brewing Lab. Which, by the way, is the Muppets again. The Muppets are around. It looks really cool.
By the way, intercot.com. This is
Sam's
like the
Disney Diary.
This is the mid,
this is
the mid-roll commercial.
Because
we had somebody come up and say, who are these guys? Where can I follow
there
them?
There you go.
There you go.
All right. All right. We did get 2 of the wings. Now, again, this year, they have the traditional buffalo wings. We have peanut butter and jelly sticky wings, garlic parmesan rings, and possible buffalo chicken tenders. Unnecessarily spicy, yet extremely tasty Carolina ripened pepper curry wings.
Yeah.
And the fried pickle spears. Now, we went with 2.
Okay.
First one we went with is.
I was concerned, by the way, that Sam was going to do this.
Unnecessarily
again this year.
Spicy yet extremely tangy Carolina Reaper pepper curry wings.
It's.
With creamy cucumber.
I remember liking this last year.
Yes.
But
it
was.
We also liked the garlic parmesan, which we got to cool this down.
Okay. All right.
And I also have a flight of beers here.
All right.
Which we may dig into before we talk about it.
Yeah, you'll have
talk
to, about those. You'll have to explain what those are at
hope
some
that
point.
I can.
Yeah,
where are we starting?
If not,
with?
They're beer, and there's a beer flight.
We going with
good.
The unnecessary.
No, we don't start with the hot one.
Why not?
We end with the hot one.
Yeah, you're right. Because
that's the way they do on hot ones. Did you see the Donald Duck hot one?
Yes, yes,
okay.
I did.
All
right. I did.
All right, here we go.
You better get one of these.
Yeah. This is required when you're eating wings. Okay. These look.
I took one right off the top.
These look pretty good. Yeah. There it is, baby. Here we go.
That's good.
Yeah, tasty.
I love the flavor. Flavorful, good, no spice at all.
All right. Not bad.
I like it.
What are you going to give it?
7.
I was going with 6.5. So, pretty similar on our guesses there. And now we've got the creme de la creme. Which
the
is
beer
the,
plate?
No. No, the unnecessarily hot wings.
No, here, you got to read it.
Oh, do I?
Yeah,
unnecessarily spicy and extremely tasty Carolina Reaper pepper curry wings. With, by the way, creamy cucumber. What is that?
Sauce.
This is the problem with doing culinary stuff. They got fancy words. And it becomes a little bit tough at times too.
Not as saucy as last year.
You know what? I want a drum. So I'm a drum guy.
Not as saucy as last
year. No, these are, but it is a little worrying here. Okay.
All right. Oh, I am opening up the side of buttermilk ranch that we got.
Oh my.
Ooh. That keeps getting hotter. I don't know if I can eat one.
It is hot.
After we dump into the pickle milkshake after this, remember?
Carolina Reaper is no joke.
Too hot for me.
Are you seeing the sweat?
Too hot for me.
Right. Yeah, I'm going to dump out. They are really hot. I mean, if you are a like super hot wings kind of person,
I'm
maybe.
Ranch dressing, that's how hot.
But yeah. Like, oh. Okay.
Right, let's get to the beers really quick.
All right.
This is
as we wrap things up.
Which, by the way, there's a beer flight and a drink flight here.
Holy moly.
The drink flight is.
Okay.
Oh, wait. Essentially. Seltzers. But forget that. Palm Paradise Hefeweizen.
Oh, I do love me a good Hefeweizen. Oh my gosh, that is hot.
This is from St. Petersburg.
That burn.
Three Daughters.
Going to go on for a while, dude.
There's also a $3 pickle hard seltzer. We did not get that.
Oh, that would have been interesting. This is really good. That's being tainted a little bit by the hot.
Yeah, it is.
But
dessert, Fleona. That's our next beer here.
What is it? This one? The middle one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dessert, Fleona with hibiscus and prickly pear.
Okay.
And the last one is Cigar Brewing Company. They didn't give us a thing, so I'm having problems.
Wow, I feel like everything in the hot wings has kind of canceled this beer out completely.
This is a peach oak white. We should have eaten these first.
Yeah, because I'm not tasting anything.
This is from Tampa. This is a peach white oak. And you're right. All I feel is heat from the Carolina Reapers.
Like, literally, this is tasting like water right now.
I know what I'm going with.
Here, try that one. See if you feel the same way. I just felt like I'm drinking water.
Wings last.
Yeah.
Wings last.
That is really hot.
I'm going back to this cake to see if that'll cool off a bit.
I am tasting the hops in that one.
Whose idea was it to get that?
When I saw him walking back with those wings after we did those last year, my lips are still tingling. You did that last year too?
I think I did. I did not.
Oh, anyway.
We got another stop.
Yeah, we do have another stop. So we crammed four in one here. Best thing here. What did you like?
Shrimp on the Barbie was pretty darn good.
You like the shrimp on the Barbie?
Shrimp on the Barbie was good.
The
noodles were better than I thought.
Actually, I would go with the noodles. And this is a close second or possibly even first.
We still have some shrimp on the Barbie. I'm going to be eating these here.
Excellent. All right. We're off to our next stop. Germany!
I see you have your fork ready, John.
I am ready.
So what do we have?
I'm ready. I'm starting to get full, too, by the way.
What do we have?
This is the... I love how you left me to do this one. This is the...
I can't even spell it.
Schinkennudeln.
Which is...
Which is pasta gratin with ham, onion, and cheese.
Sure.
The Schinkennudeln. Okay, hold on. Yeah. Holy crud.
Take it.
Okay.
Cheese is holding up the government.
That's good.
Ooh, that's heavy.
It's heavy?
It's like German lasagna.
It's exactly what it's like.
That's really what it tastes like. That's pretty good.
And it's good. I'm going to give that a 7.5.
I'll go with that.
I think it's good. I think it's really good. It's different.
I haven't had that.
It reminds me of something that my grandmother would have made years and years ago.
That is really good. Nudeln.
That is really good.
However you say that.
This next one I can say.
At Germany. Okay, what is the next one?
It is apple strudel.
Apple strudel.
With some kind of sauce, right?
Okay, yeah.
With vanilla sauce. Yeah, with that was hard.
Okay, so again, we did cut this up.
We cut it ahead of time. It looked much nicer ahead of time.
But
we're not at a table. We're just kind of standing.
No, we're just standing. And people are looking at us, but that's okay.
Ooh, that's a big
piece. We're creators. You lost one. All right, hold on. All right, hold on. I mean,
it's apple strudel. Again, that's an 8, but it has me one thing. The dessert that won last year. Yes.
I want ice cream on top of this. I don't want vanilla.
I've been looking ahead. Yes, it needs vanilla ice cream. We said the same thing last year. It needs vanilla ice cream, not vanilla sauce.
Disney, listen to us.
It needs vanilla ice cream, this, not vanilla sauce.
Yeah, this would be so much better if they had a scoop of ice cream. Even a small one right on top.
I looked ahead, which, by the way, Remy's got a little map for you here of what you like and the things that you might end up with. And I see Hawaii's on there.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's how, who knew that was inside there?
I did not know that.
Who knew?
So, they, by the way, that is part of the fun here. You pick up a festival guide, you check, you know, the things that you're interested in, and you go sampling. And then your wallet is incredibly lighter at the end of the day.
Get stamped. We're up to 2 stamps now. We have 2 things with cheese. The whatever we just ate was one of them. That will get you a completer at the end.
So the completer, do we know? Do we have any idea?
I don't know.
Last year?
It was a strawberry cheesecake with strawberry Dole Whip of some sort, if I remember right.
Yeah, it was really good.
It was good.
But you couldn't get that. You can't get that.
You have to.
Otherwise, you have to do the completer, right?
Yes, you have to have 5 stamps from 5 different places. They're all listed here, the places that you can go. We have 2 stamps so far.
Okay.
We're going to America, and I'm looking forward to the last stop.
America. Yeah, it should be good. Last year, the highest rated thing we did was there.
Well, yes, it was at the funnel cake stand, and it's different this year, and I'm not letting the cat out of the bag. We'll see it in a bit.
Okay, sounds good. Like, subscribe, do the things you do, and join us at America next. John and Sam, bye now. Hey, friends, it's the last stop on the 2024 Sam and John tour.
You make
with
it
Stacey.
Sound like it's been a burden, John.
Oh, my goodness.
It's the last stop. No, okay. I want to keep going. So,
desserts.
Well, save the best for last, hopefully. But we realized again this year, and we figured this out last year.
We did.
As well, we need to do this over 2 days.
You cannot do this in 1 day. You can't do it. We walked by 3 or 4 places before we got here. Oh. We walked by Italy. We walked by the Alps. We walked past Germany. Oh, no, we didn't. We stopped in Germany. We had some strudel. Which, by the way, that will tie right into the desserts that we have here.
Oh,
but
wow.
Before we get to desserts, this is Flavors of America.
All right.
Tell us a little bit about Flavors of America.
What do we got? We've got hot dogs. First of all, there are 4 different kinds of hot dogs here. This is what? What
do
we got
here? The New York style all beef hot dog with sauerkraut, onion, tomato sauce, spicy mustard, and a brioche bun. That's the New York style.
Okay.
That's going to be our first one.
All
you
right.
also grab the Chicago style if you want to show this one.
Yeah.
That's an all beef patty with tomato, dill pickle, pickled sport pepper, diced onions, yellow mustard, yellow green relish, and a poppy seed bun.
Nice.
Now, what we did not get because these are too big is the Carolina hot dog. Which is chili, coleslaw, yellow mustard, and brioche bun, or the Southwest style hot dog, which is wrapped in bacon. Ooh, it's wrapped in bacon, John. How do we miss that? Jalapenos, avocado, fresco, and on a French roll, lots of things. Huh. They also have a dessert here, which we'll get to in a minute, but let's talk hot dogs first.
Yeah, so first of all, these are full-size hot dogs. Did not expect that. Kind of expected them to be like mini dogs, you know, or mini conies like they used to have in Cincinnati. And these are full-size.
They still do.
By the way, we also, again, sorry, we are pre-cutting these to make it easier for us to eat.
Yes.
I am full to the gills right now, so I'm going to try one of these. I'm going to let you guys try some other stuff.
To start.
So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to try the New York style. Stacey down there is going to try the, which one was that? The Chicago style?
That's Chicago.
Okay.
The big pickle on top.
All right, this is New York style. I don't know if this is New York style. Is this really?
Good. Sauerkraut?
Okay.
That's a good New York dog.
Oh, yeah.
It is.
That's actually really good.
That's a good New York dog. Top one.
The onion tomato sauce, I think, is what makes it. That is really good. Did not expect that to be as good as it is. And really, there's sauerkraut on there, but the onion tomato sauce completely engulfs the sauerkraut and really tones it down. So if you're not a huge sauerkraut fan, go down that road.
Chicago.
Hey. Lean in.
Lean in.
Lean into the shot.
It's good. It, So if you like dill pickle, it's really good. I'm surprised too.
But you didn't like the pickle milkshake.
No.
Pickles and milk.
All right, so this is an 8 for me. I actually like this a lot.
7.5. It's still a hot dog. Mm-hmm. There's lots of things you can do, but it's good.
You know what? Sometimes a good dog is a good dog.
Yeah, I give this 7.5. It's pretty good.
7.5 from Stacy on the Chicago style dog. Nice. Okay.
I'm going to try that in a minute, but I'm going to hold back first.
Okay.
This also from Flavors of America.
Oh, man. This has bourbon in it, right?
Freshly baked chocolate pudding cake with bourbon cream.
Yes. Yes, please.
All right, who's going to be first?
All right,
I will.
Nobody else is. I want to go on the other side where there's.
Oh.
Hold on.
Hey. Listen, if you're in the chocolate, that's the bomb.
Oh, my God.
You're not going to get that again, John, just so you know.
Oh. It's like warm chocolate melting cake with bourbon sauce on the top.
9. That's a 9.
Yeah, it's a
9.
5.
Okay.
9.
Actually, so that ties for the best thing that we have had today.
Yes, it
does. At a 9.
All right, now you have to pick this one up.
I'm going to put this by Stacy because I know she's going to want to have that.
And I know we're going to want this. Here, you pick this one up.
Okay.
Because we also hit the funnel cake stand.
Holy.
The funnel cake stand has been the hidden gem of this festival. This is the tiramisu funnel cake. Vanilla ice cream, chocolate rum sauce, cream cheese whipped cream on top of that thing.
Come on.
Dusted with cocoa and espresso powder. That is the tiramisu cheesecake.
You had me at tiramisu, but
funnel cake.
Okay, so we should have pre-cut this. But
we should have, but it doesn't matter. What I love about it is because that's a cream cheese whipped cream, it's not melting at all.
Right,
it is staying together in the sun.
Let's pan down.
Look, and it is. I don't know why I'm even trying to cut it. It's a funnel cake. Just getting into it.
Yeah, I don't know what you're doing either. But
I don't know. I'm just getting into it.
But get some of that cream up top, too.
Most definitely.
Oh. Wow, this is surprisingly difficult. It's like...
Oh.
Trying to get into a squid or something. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna pan up again. Okay, here we go. Yeah.
It's good. I want to say I like last year's better.
I'm with you.
I like the caramel one last year. I really like this bourbon cream.
No,
I think the bourbon cream cake is better.
I think, honestly, right now, having skipped over some things, this wins the day.
Yes.
This is the clear festival winner. Honestly, if you've ever been on Carnival Cruise Lines and had the chocolate melting cake, it's very similar to that, only with the caramel bourbon instead of, they basically put some ice cream or something on top, which, by the way, this would be excellent with a scoop of ice cream on the side.
We have the ice cream on
as well.
Here.
Yeah.
So, maybe we're onto something. We mix these two things together. I'm not going to do that, though. But.
I don't know. But the hot dog's not bad either. And you still have to go on and
I have more things to try. Although, you know, we talked before about these guys, right?
Right.
This time, the first time this year, there is a guide for families. And what this has is highlighted all of the things going on for kids here around Epcot for the festival.
Yep.
And of course, it talks about DuckTales, which is the World Showcase Adventure. But you missed the DuckTales. There he goes.
Oh,
he was
sorry.
A little slow that time, but he got it. this, I think, is really cool. Something for the kids to check out. And Remy's adventures going on, the hide and squeak.
Yeah.
Lots of stuff happening.
Lots of cool stuff at the Epcot International 2024. I'm jumbling it all up.
Food and Wine Festival,
which is the important part. Tons of great booths. Easy to go through a lot of money. But
yeah, that's true.
Way fun to try all the different things that we've tried. And we did a couple things before Sam even got here because he was a little late.
I'm going to do a couple things after John leaves.
So either way, follow both of us
on
the Facebooks, all the socials.
That's right. SamsDisneyDiary.com is where you're going to find me.
Sam's Disney Daily on Instagram. You'll find me there too.
Okay, cool. And just head to intercot.com. Up the top of the site is the social nav bar. Just click on them all, subscribe to them all. Great. And then Stacy and I tonight. What are you?
You're gonna eat the hot dog?
Yeah. Stacy and I are headed to the Magic Kingdom tonight, and we're gonna have some fun over there.
Nice.
Because we got here a little earlier than Sam.
Is it a Halloween party tonight?
I don't think so. Is it?
Well, I hope not, because if it is, you're not gonna be.
Well,
that
if it is, then we're yeah out of luck.
I think that was last night.
Okay. Anyway. No, I think we're good to go. Anyway, great day here at the Epcot International Food and Wine Festival. Thank you. As always, to my man, the guy.
Thank you, John. It's been fun.
Yeah, Sam from Sam's Disney Diary. Thank you to my wife, Stacy, down there. Stacy tries today.
Yes.
And, of course, for me, John. Bye now.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit that subscribe button. John from Intercut, thank you, as always. I cannot wait to do that again for the next festival. Make sure you hit subscribe here at Sam's Disney Diary. Go check out Intercut's. Call the loose. We'll see you next time.